So I apologize. I'm in my basement. The lighting stinks. It's nighttime, so there's not a lot of natural light. I probably should have shot this during the day, but when you have time, you might as well utilize it. So I just wanted to give a quick summary and kind of describe what this video is all about. It's about an unusual species in Massachusetts that doesn't get a whole lot of attention, that's just starting to get it now a little bit. Massachusetts bowfin. I've caught them in Florida, but I wanted to catch them here at home. Originally, when I started fishing the Taunton River for bowfins, it really just started out with just, you know, being a multi-species angler, just going out and targeting something different to break up the, you know, the same old, same old. That's how I enjoy fishing. It's part of it for me. Some guys like to chase the same species over and over again. That's not what I like to do, but I certainly have my favorites like everybody else. But anyways, so I started fishing for these bowfins with just the intention of catching one. So I finally got one right on the first trip this year with a buddy of mine. He got one too, and it progressed. And then I wanted to catch more than one. I wanted to catch a few, and then it went from that to just wanting to get a large specimen, and then it went from that to trying to break the state record. The bowfin species is a new one for the record books. Mass Wildlife didn't start recognizing them as a game fish until 2015, and they started giving out state award pens for it as well. So I decided to go for it. Currently, there's an 8-1 leading the weight category, and I believe I hooked a fish that definitely broke that weight and came off at the boat. These fish, these bowfins, have some pretty sharp teeth. You have to keep that in mind when you're fishing for them, so you can lose them time to time, and unfortunately the one that mattered the most came off, which is, I was not happy. But August and September, or most of those 2 months, I broke the catch and release record and had it for a short period, but I had it temporarily. It's before it got broken by a half inch. But I don't imagine that that's going to last very long. And same thing with the weight class record, the 8-1. Then I believe that next year or the year after, those records will break again. And who knows, maybe I'll be the guy to do it. I know where they live. It depends on how much time I'm going to put into it. But so because it's a new, fairly new species, the record is attainable for those of you willing to go out and chase them. I'm trying to get information on how to catch them here in Mass. I noticed that there is like no information on Massachusetts bowfin on the internet. Very little. And YouTube was even worse. There was zero Massachusetts bowfin fishing video content. Zero. So as far as I know, once I publish this video, this will be the first one, which is kind of surprising, but not so surprising since we only have two viable fisheries in the state, which is the Connecticut River and the Taunton River. I went online and, you know, read a bunch of things. I didn't know whether the tactics that worked down south would work here in my home state. So I sort of had to wing it a little bit and try to figure it out for myself, and also a buddy of mine. We kind of learned off of each other a little bit. One of the interesting things I found about the Taunton River too, while exploring for bowfins, is the variety of fish that are in there. So like and subscribe to this video. If it gets enough positive feedback, I'm going to make another bowfin video. And in that one, I'll actually cover particular spots and methods and tactics and whatnot on how to catch these bowfins here in Massachusetts. I mean, it's not rocket science or anything all that surprising, but there are some small details that you should be aware of that'll make a big difference. If you'd like to see a video like that in the future, subscribe. So without further ado, here's my attempt at bowfin fishing in Massachusetts this year, 2017. Taunton River. Check it out. Me and my buddy Roger, Aziz, decided to try our luck with the bowfin, and sure enough, you know, nice when you go after the target and you get it. Hopefully we get into some more. So Roger just banged out his own bowfin. We came out here with a mission to try to get one of these and get two. 24 and a quarter.
Here's Roger's Bowfin Beauty. Gave him a good run. Nice. What an awesome fish, Roger.
Awesome.
Beauty. Yeah, we both banked some out. Awesome.
Some bowfin fishing.
I got a bowfin on
it. I got them. I like targeting these guys. They're very interesting looking fish. Sick. So sweet. What a gorgeous fish. Prehistoric. These things swam with the dinosaurs. 150 million years ago, and they're still around. Look at a tail. Hey, look, he's got some serious teeth. Nasty. Look at that. Look at that. They are something else. Toothy. The fins. That thing. They're very neat looking. All right, we're gonna let this bowfin go. Landed a big bass on top of that bowfin earlier. Did the same thing last week. How big is this one? This one looks like he's been caught before. Got another bowfin on, big one. Get him up. PB. Oh yeah. Bigger than any of the other ones I've gotten so far. Woo!
He's a big boy.
It's gotta be my PB. Yeah. Put them in the corner. Look at those teeth. The barbells. Oh yeah. That helps weigh them. Oh yeah. 7'8", 7'10", 7'12", 7'11". 7'11" it is.
A new PB, 7 pounds, 11 ounces. I weighed it on 2 digital scales. And if we get it, I'm gonna take a measurement of it too. Here it is, monster. Look at that fin, Jesus. The teeth on this thing, Jesus. Dinosaur. It really is a dinosaur. These things go back to like 150 million years. They were around when the dinosaurs were around. So pumped about this fish. Definitely a pinfish. Been trying to actually get the record, but I'm getting closer and closer. But we'll see what happens. What a beast. Monster. A new species I've been targeting this year and having a lot of fun chasing these guys. They're a whole lot of fun. I'm going to measure them out right now after I get some pictures. Holy crap, it's 29 inches. What a beast. Jeez. Huge little tail on that thing. Monster. 29 inches long. He's gulping air in the live well. I'm gonna let him go. It's windy, cloudy, it's coming. Storm forecast projected it too, and I just sense the rain's coming, so I want to get the hell out of here. Small one on. Landed it. Oh man, I'm still bummed over that other one.
Been chasing these guys quite a bit. Probably like my, third trip for them this year. I had one that was definitely a state record weight-wise. I ended up getting the catch and release record, but I got one that blew away the 8 pounds, 1 ounce. Totally blew it away. I was trying to net it. The hook came undone while I was netting, right at the tail edge of the net too. I couldn't believe it. Back, I know where they live. So, still got this one though. Pretty happy with it. They're just so neat looking. I can't help but chase these guys. I just can't help it. They're just such interesting fish. And they fight so good and they pull so hard. Definitely worth pursuing. Stuff on the river today. Got some really nice bass. I got the sweet crappie. Nice bullhead. A bunch of perch today in the mix. Oh, these guys are fun. So are the other fish. But be back for more. And let these guys go.
I highly advise you to not lip these fish, otherwise you're going to get a free acupuncture treatment.
Look at this tail on this thing, all bloody battered, 4 wounds. Nasty, huh? Small guy. I'll catch these guys. Chasing bowfins again today. Both decent ones. I got one just over 5 and another 4.7. They seem to average in the 4.6, 4.5, 4.7 range. Couple of beauties. The tail on this one, fresh wound from something biting it. Some beauties though, for sure. Not bad. Let these go in a minute.
catch them. There's a bunch of them in the river. Is that neat or what? Hickory shad. Pretty cool.
Some interesting surprises. I didn't know there was a viable fishery for hickory shad in the river. I've fished for and heard of American shad, which are much bigger, but the hickory shad is sort of a smaller cousin. But man, you know, pound for pound, they fight amazing. But I was losing a lot of them. They have like sort of like paper soft mouths, so you have to go very easy on them while you're reeling them up and give them all the drag in the world and just take it slow and easy and keeping your rod tip down at all times. It seemed like for every one I landed, I lost three, or some crazy ratio like that.
Check it out. Something tried to eat this one. Crazy, huh?
I headed out there specifically to target Bowfin and to go for a record, at least attempt to go for the record. I found myself spending the day catching hickory shad. The water was flat and calm, wasn't much wind, and the hickory shad are actually rising. And I was wondering what kind of fish these were, and I was casting all kinds of things trying to figure out how to catch them. And I finally put something together and started catching them.
That's how you catch a shad.
I got into a ton of them. You lose more than you catch. You gotta use real light line and go real easy on them. Old hickory shad. I didn't know this river offered such a great fishery for them. I kind of ignored the boat in a little bit to catch these guys. So I'm gonna hang on to these and use them for bait.
Check this one out. Looks a little different than the others.
And I got another surprise and caught my first pogie. I don't normally catch them on rod and reel, usually snagging them or throwing a cast net for those. Bass bite was also on. That also pulled me away from the bowfin.
Nice one.
The largemouth are bigger than average, which doesn't surprise me with so much for them to eat.
Look at mouth.
Schools of bayfish.
Always get big bass out of this river.
These bass, they get big in this river. They feed on these shad.
Bowfin today. All right, we did well today. Roger got two. I got a 6-9. Penfish. Roger got the numbers today. We did good. He's gonna let it go.
End up liking this video, go to my Instagram page where you'll see unseen photos that were not shown in this video. And don't forget to like and follow. So that was a lot of fun.